Yeah, but I'm sending 5,000, more than 1,000.
Yes.
So what it's going to do, it's going to slow down, or maybe it's going to shut down. It won't work properly. So this is what DOS is basically. We send some, we just flood the any web application or any protocol or any service. So in order for that service to not work properly, so either we want them to shut down, we want them to slow down. So this is the purpose of DOS. So basically there are two types of DOS, so like DOS and DDoS. So what DOS is, if we are performing denial of like if we are performing DOS with one PC and one internet connection, then it's DOS. And if we are doing with multiple PC and multiple internet connection, then it's DDoS. So that's the only difference between these two. So obviously if you are if you attack from one PC, then nothing is going to happen, because like anything, even if you do DOS attack from your PC to your another PC, I don't think anything is going to happen, because one PC won't make much impact. But if you perform with like 1 lakh PC, 100,000,
Yes.
200,000, 10,000 PC, then obviously, and if you perform out like if you do one attack from 1,000 PC on a single computer, then the computer is going to like it will be shut down. It won't, it will just get corrupted. It won't work properly. So it might shut down, or it might hang or slow down. So that's what gonna happen. So what attackers do usually, we do DDoS attack, because DOS won't make anything. So its impact will be very low. So we don't do DOS, we do denial of service. So from multiple PC. So which is why attackers spread Trojans, and which is why they use botnet. So attackers like hack multiples of computers, like thousands of computers, in order to do DOS attack. So that's the purpose, main purpose. So how DDoS works? So basically we just flood. So there are various things which we can do. So the first thing is flooding the victim system with more traffic than it can handle. So sending them request, sending them traffic more than they can handle. So if they can handle 1,000, we will send 2,000. So anything, flooding a service with more events that it can handle. So crashing a transmission control protocol or internet protocol, TCP/IP stack, by sending corrupted packets. So crashing a service by interacting with an unexpected way, or hanging a system by causing it to go into infinite loop. So there are various purposes, so there are various methods through which we can do. So let's look at the DOS/DDoS attack technique. So there are three techniques, so three types of DOS attacks. So first one is volumetric, second is protocol, and third is application layer. So what is volumetric attack is, basically we will send a large volume of traffic. So as we see here, so flooding the victim system with more traffic than it can handle. And in this we will do UDP flood. So, and if we talk about protocol attack, so in protocol we compromise, like we attack on layer 3 and 4 of OSI, of OSI model. So what is layer 3 and 4? So network layer and transport layer. So we take advantage of TCP/IP.
Okay.
So
Okay.
like TCP protocol and UDP protocol. So this is the protocol. So we just try to take advantage of vulnerabilities within protocol. So through this we do attacks. And application layer is layer 7. So layer 7, all like all the applications. So all the applications that runs on layer 7. So like we can do HTTP flood. So or any attack like on web applications. So basically we can perform DOS attack on web applications. So any website you can, so So if you are performing DOS DDoS attack on any website, then it will be called application layer. If you are taking advantage of any protocol, so any protocol based attack, then it will be called protocol attack. And if we are sending huge amount of data, so no matter it's host or it's anything, it's web server, it's host or it's anything, then it will be called volumetric attack, because we are sending large amount of volume, large traffic to the destination, to our target. So these are the attack techniques. So UDP flood attack, which we will do in volumetric, ICMP flood attack, so ping of death attack, smurf attack, thin flood attack, fragmentation attack. So these are the type of attacks. So basically the all attacks have the same purpose. So if we add the base of DOS is to just send as many requests as you can. So whether you will do UDP, ICMP, ping of tens, so every attack have the same purpose, to send, just flood the target with either by taking advantage of this protocol, by taking advantage of this, or by taking advantage of this. So the primary purpose of DOS is to just flood the target with any sort of request. So it can be a protocol based, or it's any sort of request. So that is DOS DDoS. The main purpose of we can say the base of DOS DDoS is to just send traffic as much as you can, because everything has a limit no matter what. So no matter how much money you spent on a web server, how much money you spent on an operating system or a system, so everything has a limit, and the purpose of DOS to exceed to that limit. So if a system has 1 Gbps limit, so it can handle 1 GB, 1 million users, then we will send 2 million. So if it can take 1 Gbps traffic, then what we are going to do, we can send 2 Gbps traffic. So it's all about exceeding the limit of our target. So that's the main point of DOS DDoS attack. So, and if we talk about botnets, so like I told you, attackers spread free softwares. So users will buy download free software, and in free softwares we have backdoors or trojan or any sort of worm or virus, and through any method, the purpose is to just compromise as many system as we can, so that we can make a botnet. So if we hack one PC, then it will be called a bot. If we hack multiple PC, then it will be called botnet. So for the primary purpose of botnet is to do DDoS attack, because if a hacker wants to shut down any website, then he has to send a request from as many PC as he can, because if he will send request from his own PC, nothing is going to happen. Even if how many PC can you buy? You cannot buy 1 million PC. You can buy 100 PC or 200 PC. So even if you buy 100 PC, nothing is going to happen. So you need millions of PC, at least thousands of PC to attack. So what attackers do, they spread free software, people will fall into that, people will download, and people's PC got compromised. And when multiple PC compromised, we get a botnet, and there will be a bot automated script which will control these botnets. So it will give instruction to these, and based on, and the purpose of this, main purpose of this is DDoS, but with botnet we can do a lot of things. So as you can see, apart from DDoS, we can do spamming. So we can send marketing emails or spam emails to thousands of, so if your PC can send 1000 spam emails in 1 day, then if you have 10,000 PC, then you can send millions of spam emails to millions of people per day. So not only for DDoS attack, but we also use a botnet for spamming, sniffing traffic, key logging, spreading new malware. So if you have like thousands of compromised PC, you can use those PCs to spread your malware more aggressively, and installing advertisement add-ons. So there are various purposes of botnets. So let's look at the attacking tools. So these two tools are very popular. So high orbit ion cannon and low orbit ion cannon. But it is very difficult to find these tools without virus. So if you search and you will download, you will definitely receive a virus. So you can get in one click, but it's better to use this. So as you can see, malware detected, download at own risk. So it's better to just use this inside your virtual system, or it's not advised to use these at in your main PC. So LOIC, like this tool got famous by Anonymous. So previously this tool was like very low level, like it wasn't very popular. People, not many people know about this, but there is a hacking group called Anonymous who used this tool to perform DDoS attack on one of his target, and using this tool they shut down the website of their target. So after that this tool got famous. So previously it wasn't very famous. So you can use these tools, but apart from these tools there are hundreds of tools on GitHub, on everywhere, which you can find. So let me tell you.
Okay, sir.
I have pre-installed, so let me show you one of the tools. If you want to use these tools, then you have to shut down your antivirus, because the moment you will download these tools, if your Windows Defender or any antivirus is on, they will just remove these. So you have to turn down, and it's not like they will 100% chance they will contain virus, so it's not good to use them in your own system. So if I open Google and if I type DDoS tools GitHub, then you will get to see. So this is the topic. And here you will get all the different tools by different persons, different developers who have created these tools. So you can install any of these tools, but let me show you which tools I installed. So the tool I have is DDoS attack. So what you can do, you can search this and so this is the tool I use. Yes, this is the tool which I have, and the download installation is very simple. You just need to copy these, paste inside your terminal. I already have. After pasting this, just copy this and paste inside your terminal, copy this, paste inside your terminal, copy this, paste inside your terminal, and your tool will start. So its installation is very simple. So let us see how to use this tool. So if I do cd DDoS attack, if I do ls, so this is the tool. So let's run this. So this is the command .slash. To execute any file you can use .slash and the file, whether it's Python, it's Perl, it's Ruby, it's Bash, so it doesn't matter.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so it is taking time. Let me just close this whole thing. cd2 cd dot slash. It should work actually. Python DDoS. So yeah, don't use dot slash. I think dot slash is making some trouble. So I need to use this Python DDoS. So now the tool is open. It is asking for IP address, and here you can give IP address of even a system, or even a website. So it. You cannot enter like google.com, just you have to give IP. Or for demo I'm going to give my system IP. So this is my IP and I'm going to give this, and there might be chance when the attack will happen, then there might be chance that my internet got disconnected or I have to reconnect. So I'm telling you in advance, because in previous lecture there were some issues with that. So let's see if it happens this time or not. So now the attack will start once this will reach 100%. So 25, 50, 75 and 100. So the attack starts. You can see it is going to send, so 14,000, 17,000, the packets are going to increase.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is how we do. So, okay, so everything is fine. That's good. Let me see if it increases, anything happens. Okay, so it's a good thing it can handle. So I think it can handle all the request, but if we leave it like that, there might be some issue. 130. So it just keeps ending and nothing is happening. So I guess we have to do it with multiple PCs. So this is the drawback of one PC. So you can't disrupt if you are attacking from one PC. You have to have like multiple PC. So previously it happens, but currently it is not doing anything. So this is for a system, and let me tell you if if you want to perform on a website, you just have to give the IP. So here, if I once again enter in this, and if I once again run this, so yeah, now it will ask for IP. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to give host and certified hacker.com. And let us see, this is the IP, copy the IP, paste the IP, port number, I want to target port 80, whether it's gonna happen. You can give any port number you want. certified hacker. It got reloaded, so there is nothing, it is not loading. So if I reload this, the process will got finished, so the page will open. So now notice if I do attack and once the attack start and once I reload, it won't reload, it will slow down. So just wait. The website got slowed down because of the attack.
So, yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is one thing, and there is also a tool called Thor's Hammer. I guess it's also a good tool for DDoS. Yeah, Hammer. Thor's Hammer perform DDoS. Yeah, Thor's Hammer. Yes. So this is also a Thor's Hammer tool. So for DDoS tools written in Python, so it is also used for DDoS attacks. So there are various you will find on GitHub, and even if you want like Windows, so you can get DDoS attack tools for Windows. So apart from LOIC and HOIC, you will also get some other GUI. So as you can see, it is showing LOIC, HOIC. So apart from these two, you can download Slowis, GoldenEye, XOIC, TOS hammer, so THC. So these are some powerful TOS DDoS attacking tools. Okay, so that is for Linux, but there will be. So this is for Windows. Linux and Windows both. So that. So this is how otherwise you look. You have to enter the URL. Once you press this, it's going to attack. GoldenEye. HYC is similar to LYC. You have to just, it's a GY tool. XYC, so it is a Windows based tool. Rudy, it is also a Windows. So TOS hammer. THC. So these are various tools. Even you can do it with your own Android. So I think your phone must be, it should be rooted to do this. So
okay.
If your phone is rooted in Android, you can do a lot of things. So we will talk about them in mobile hacking in different modules. So this was some tools, and let me tell you one more method. So synflood. So synflood attack using metasploitable, sorry, metasploit framework. We also can do DDoS attack. So
okay.
So it is now open. So let's search synflood. So these are all the attack which we can perform. So here I'm going to do auxiliary DOS TCP synflood. Copy and use. So it is loaded. Options. So target host, so it will use the port 80. So okay, set R host 192.168.0.117. R host is set. I don't need to set anything. Now I am going to do exploit, and it is going to flood my PC with SYN request.
Yes.
So this is how it is not going to show anything. So it is looking SYN flooding. So that it means the attack is going on. So it, unlike other like DDoS attack tools which I showed you, it is not going to show all the packets which is being sent. So this is how you can do SYN flooding. So what it does, the concept behind SYN flooding is. You know about three way handshake, so where we, whenever we want
yes.
to communicate with any system, any PC, any server, so we need to do three way handshake. So we will send a SYN, then we will receive the SYN ACK, and then we will send ACK. So in SYN flooding, what it is going to do, it is continuously going to send SYN request to the target. So, and the thing with the SYN request is, whenever you receive a SYN request from any person, any system, then you have to open you have to keep that request for 75 seconds. So imagine this send a SYN request, and the target PC will send SYN and ACK, but it will not send the acknowledgement. So if it will send acknowledgement, that handshake will completed and the connection will establish, but it will not send acknowledgement. So what because of that, the handshake will fail, handshake will not completed, and the rule for the SYN is if there is a failed handshake, then the target PC who is receiving the SYN request has to keep the request for 75 seconds. So if it sends send request, then the target PC have to store that send request for 75 seconds even after the TCP handshake is not happening. So even if TCP handshake is not happening, it is a rule to store that request for 75 seconds. So imagine in 75 seconds it can send like thousands of requests. So it is a weakness, we can say a weakness in the protocol, which we take advantage of. So it is just going to send sin, and when the target will send sinet, it is not going to respond, it will just send sin. So this is how we do the sin attack. Let me close this. So the attack is closed. So these were the some of the tools, and let me tell you one more. So there is a script, so let me show you. You can so here when we were discussing DOS VNF attack technique, so there was also a technique called ping of death. It is quite famous, but if you do it from one system, then it is not also very effective. So let me show you what a ping of death attack is. So you can do ping of death from your terminal. So the concept is just you have to ping. So if I ping my Linux PC, so so 0.1.1.2. So the concept is when you do ping one time, it will send 32 bytes of data for one time, and it will tell you the operating system based on if it's 64 then it's Linux, if it's 128 then it's Windows. So that is how we identify operating system. If the time to TTL value is 64, then it means it's a Linux based system, and if TTL value is 128, then it means it's a Windows based system. So it will send 32 bytes of data, and after it sent 4 packet, it will receive 4 packet. It identified that the host is up, it is receiving data, it is sending data. So this is for one simple ping command, and the purpose of DOS is to just flood anything. So you can flood any request. So if we do one time ping, it's just normal, but if we do continuous ping, and not with 32 bytes of data, but with maximum bytes of data that we can send with ping is 65,500. So what we do in ping of death is we will continuously send ping request to the target, and with 65,500 bytes of data, not with 32. 32 is very small. So let me show you how you can do. You can open hundreds of terminals in your system, but that is not very efficient. So there is a way. So it's just a simple script. So it's just a loop, and in loop I am giving my Linux operating system IP, and here I am giving 65,500 bytes of data, and these are some other requests which I am giving. And thing is, when the loop starts, the loop ends here, and I will just send it to the loop again. So it will start, it will end, and then it will go to again. So it will be continuous. So let me show you. So and you just need to open Notepad, paste this, and you have to save that with .bat extension. For bat file, because it's a batch file, so you have to save this with .bat, not with .txt. So if I press enter, you are going to see it is going to send thousands of ping requests. So it is going to send 65,500 packets to my Linux PC. So and it is going if I don't stop it, it is going to continue. So let me stop this.
Yes,
so this is what a ping of death is. We just send thousands of ping requests to the target, and there are various methods. This is just a small simple script, and if you search on internet, there are other type of method, other type of script, but the concept is we just send ping request, nothing else. There might be some other method, but in those method also you will be sending ping request. So this is what ping of death is, and yeah, these are the type of attacks, and using tools you can do these sort of attacks. And we already discussed botnets and DDoS attack tools, and now these were the attack tools. And let me just write, we can do with Metasploit and various GitHub tools and various Windows tools, GUI based tools we can use also. So DOS, DDoS protection tools. So these were the attacking tools and how to protect. So these are the tools which protects. So if I search this, I'm sure these were some paid, obviously, because these were some industry level tools which you can use. So to protect DDoS protection for websites, for networks and domain name servers, DNS server and IP, so it will provide protection. And sometimes when you open any website, you saw like this, if I have to open, you will see sometimes when you open any website, okay, so it is not showing Cloudflare. So like the page we built in a social engineering, so if I show you Cloudflare DDoS protection, I open this. Yes, so sometimes when you open a website, you might see these type of images. So checking your browser before accessing this some sort of website, so yes, you might have seen these images. So this is used for DDoS protection. So as you can see, it will be written in that page as DDoS protection. So before opening the website, if you use Cloudflare, so if you use this Cloudflare protection tool, then before opening any website, the Cloudflare will check your browser that the request is genuine. So if it detects that there are thousands of requests coming, then it will just block you. It will block your IP. So this is Cloudflare protection, and these are some other tools which is used to protect against DDoS. So this is the whole DDoS the whole DDoS model. So the main concept of DDoS is to just flood the target. So whether with SYN flooding or UDP flooding or even a ping flooding, ICMP flooding, so HTTP flooding. So anyway, you just have to send hundreds of thousands of millions of requests instead of one. So the base concept is just this. So this is what DDoS is, and there are tools which you can use to attack. So that's which we already discussed, and these are the production tools, and these are three types. So volumetric, protocol, application. So they are divided in three, but all of them have same purpose, to just flood the target with thousands of requests. So they are different, but the goal is same. So they take advantage of different layers a different method, but they all three of them have the same goal, to just flood the victim. So with the request, so this is what DDoS is, and if you want to ask anything, you can ask. Or
sir, can you share some resources to create some tools?
To create some tools, which
yes,
sort of tools?
Like these DDoS tools or any type of tools, where can I learn?
If you want to learn about DDoS and DDoS tools, so okay.
If I want to create my own tool, how to?
Own, so if you like, wait a second, so if you want to make tools like these, so which I just show you, like all the tools, so whatever tools you saw on GitHub, if you want to make tools like that, then obviously you need to learn a programming language. Without programming language, you can't. So there are some courses on internet.
Language?
Python.
Okay.
So Python is the best programming language. So almost every tool. So let me just open my terminal. If I show you tools, ls, so even almost if you want to make tools like these, so like the social engineering tool that I show you, the DDoS attack tool, or any type of tool you want, so the thing you need to know any programming language, but Python is quite easy to learn and Python is very good. So what I can show you, there are some websites like, so let me
so in this diploma I have Python module, I think.
Yeah, in this diploma you have Python module, but I'm not sure what they are going to teach you, so they might teach you to build some tools, so I don't have idea about that. So